So we just now we studied how to represent this tree using a linked list representation. Now we'll try to store this tree using array representation or sequential representation. So the amount of space that is to be reserved for array is given by 2 to the power of l plus 1, where l is nothing but height of the tree. You can see the height of the tree, which is nothing but the length of the longest path. So the path, longest path is from A to M, and it is of size 3. So the total amount of space that we require is 2 to the power of 3 plus 1 minus 1, which is nothing but equal to 15. Or we can say if starts from index 0, then it is from 0 to 14. So this is the array that we require of the size 15, starting from 0 to 14. Always the root node will be stored at the 0th location. So we store the root node A at the 0th location. We'll write the address here 0. The next node you have to consider is the left child of A, which is nothing but B. And we know the address of the left child will be given by 2 star P plus 1, where P is nothing but the address of parent of whatever child we are considering here. So in that case, B is the left child. So address of the left child will be given by 2 star P plus 1. And the parent of B is A, which is having the address 0. So in that case, it will be calculated as 2 star 0 plus 1, which is equal to 1. So B will be stored at the location 1. So we'll write it as 1 here. Coming to the next one, X. X is again a left child of B. So the address again 2 star P plus 1. But now the parent of X is B, whose address is 1. So this will become 2 star 1 plus 1. So 2 star 1 plus 1 is nothing but equal to 3. So the child X will be stored in the location 3. Y is a right child, so the address will be 2 star P plus 2. For Y, the parent is B, address of B is 1, so this will become 2 star 1 plus 2, which is nothing but equal to 4. So in the 4th location, the node Y is stored. Coming to the right subtree, C, it's a right child, so address will be 2 star P plus 2. And for the node C, the parent is A, address is 0, so it will become 2 star 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. So now we store C at the location 2. Next we have Z. Z is again a right child, so it is 2 star P plus 2. For Z, the parent is C, the address of C is 2. So in that case, it is 2 star 2 plus 2. So it is 2 star 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. In the 6th location, the node Z has to be stored. And finally, M, it is again a right child of Z. So the address will be 2 star P plus 2, and it's a child of Z. Z is at the location 6. So the address of M is 2 star 6 plus 2, which is nothing but equal to 14. So it is stored here. And all other spaces which we can see here, these are the blank spaces. So when we compare this with the linked list representation, we saw that the number of nodes in the tree, the same number of nodes we require when you want to represent it using linked list. There is no wastage of space. But when we represent the same tree using array representation, we can see there is a lot of wastage of space depending upon what kind of binary tree we are going to store. For this binary tree, we can see the spaces are wasted because X doesn't have two children, Y doesn't have children, C has only one child, Z has only one child. So all those spaces which are reserved are here empty space. But the same if you had considered a complete binary tree, for example, A, B, C, X, Y, let us say M and P. So what is the height of the tree here? 2. So total amount of space we require is 2 to the power of 2 plus 1 minus 1. That is 2 to the power of 3 minus 1, 8 minus 1, 7. That means from 0 to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we again start. A is stored at the 0th position because it's a root node. Then we have B, which is a child of A, left child. So it will be stored at the location 1. C, it's a right child of A, address of A is 0. So 2 star 0 plus 2, it is equal to 2. So C is stored here. Then coming to X, I'll write the addresses. This is 0, 1 and 2. X is a left child of B, B address is 1. So X will be stored in the location 2 star 1 plus 1. That is nothing but equal to 3. So X is stored here. Y will be stored at the location 2 star 1 plus 2 because Y is a right child. So the address is 4. Similarly, M and P will be stored in the location 5 and 6 respectively. So when the tree is a complete binary tree, in that case, even sequential array representation will have no wastage of memory. Whereas when we have the tree which is not a complete binary tree, we can see it's not an effective way of representing the binary tree using sequential representation. Thank you. So today we'll try to understand what are the various ways in which the binary tree can be traversed. So binary tree traversal. So there are three methods: pre-order, tree traversal, in order tree traversal, and post order tree traversal. So you must have heard about the three terms: pre-order, in-order, post-order, with respect to prefix, infix and postfix types of expression. In case of prefix expression, we had studied that the operator appears before the two operands, hence it was called as prefix expression. In case of in-order, the operator used to appear in between the two operands, hence it was called as infix expression. And in case of postfix expression, the operator used to appear after the operands. So those were the three types of arithmetic expression. Similarly, we have three types of traversal: pre-order, in-order and post-order. Depending upon when the parent node is processed compared to its left child and right child. In case of pre-order tree traversal, first the parent node is processed, followed by the left child, followed by the right child. Since the parent is processed before left and right child, it is called as pre-order tree traversal. In case of in-order tree traversal, first left child is traversed, followed by the parent node, followed by the right child. So the parent is processed in between the left child and the right child, hence it is an in-order tree traversal. And the third type, post-order, first we process the left child, followed by the right child, and finally the parent. So the parent is processed after the left child and the right child, and so it's called as post-order tree traversal. So now, having said that, we'll try to perform the three kind of tree traversals on a given binary tree. Let us assume a binary tree A, B, C, X, Y, Z, M. So let us assume that C doesn't have a left child. So this is the binary tree that we have considered, and let us try to perform the tree traversal on the given binary tree. So first we'll perform pre-order tree traversal. So in case of pre-order tree traversal, as we have seen, the parent has to be processed before the left child and the right child. So always we start first from the root node, and now this itself is a parent, so it should be processed first. So it is processed first. After processing parent, we need to move towards the left child. So left child is B. Again, P is now a parent, so B should be processed. Again, move to the left child of B, it is X. X, it doesn't have any children, so it is the left child. So after printing the parent, the left child has to be printed, so X is printed. After the parent and the left child is printed, now we can process the right child. So the right child Y is processed. So we have processed the parent, the left child, the right child, and there is nothing else to process in the left subtree. We go back to the root node, and the root node is already printed. The left child is also processed. So now we need to move towards the right subtree. When we move towards the right subtree, we have the node C. So it's a parent node. So it is processed. So C is processed. After processing, we should move towards the left, but since it doesn't have a left child, we move towards the right. And now this is a parent, so the parent is processed. After that, again we process the left child, but it doesn't have a left child, so we move towards the right, and the right child is processed or printed. So the pre-order tree traversal is A, B, X, Y, C, Z, and M. So in pre-order traversal, the parent will be processed before the children. And among the left and the right child, the left child is always processed before the right child. The next kind of traversal we'll study is in-order tree traversal. In in-order tree traversal, as we studied, the parent is processed in between the left and the right. In the sense, first the left child is processed, followed by the parent, then followed by the right child. So let us perform the in-order traversal on this binary tree. we start with the root node, but the root node cannot be processed because it's a parent, and in order, the parent must be processed only after the right child is processed. So we'll move towards the left of A, that is B is the left child of A. But again, this cannot be processed. The reason is this B is a parent for which a left child exists. So the parent cannot be processed unless and until the left child is processed. So we'll move towards the left child of B, that is X. Now with respect to X, there is no left child, and hence now we can process the X. So we'll write here X. In simple terms, in case of in-order tree traversal, we need to traverse from the root towards the left till we reach the leftmost leaf node. So we have processed the leaf node first. After processing the leaf node, we need to process the parent child, and B is the parent of X, so B is processed. After processing the left child and the right child, we move towards the right child. The right child doesn't have children, so in that case it can be processed, so Y is processed. So we have processed the left child, the parent, and the right child. Then we move back. The parent of B is A, and with respect to A, the left child is processed, so now we can process the parent, that is A. After processing the left child and the parent, now we move towards the right. Coming towards the right, C is the right child of A. It should not be processed because we should check for the left child. Since it doesn't have a left child, C will be processed. After processing the parent, we'll move toward the right, and again Z doesn't have a left child, so Z will be processed. And after processing the parent, we move towards the right, and it's a child, it doesn't have children, so M will be processed. So the outcome of the in-order tree traversal is the left child, parent, right child, the entire left subtree is printed, then the root node A, and now we are supposed to print the right subtree by again performing the in-order tree traversal. So C, next Z, and next M. And finally, we'll perform the last type of traversal, that is post-order tree traversal. In case of post-order tree traversal, the parent has to be processed after the left child and the right child. So again, we start from the root node. A is the parent. It cannot be processed unless and until its children, both B and C, are processed. And first we should move towards the left child, so we move towards B. B is not printed because it's a parent. So first children should be processed, so we move towards the left child of B, which is nothing but X. So the first child that is processed is X. And X is a leaf node, it doesn't have children, X is processed. After processing the left child, we have to move towards the right child. The right child is Y. So we have now traversed both the left and the right child. So now we can traverse the parent, that is B. So the post-order traversal, left child, right child, and then the parent. And then we come back to B. B is a left child of A. It is already processed. So move towards the parent. Parent cannot be processed because you are doing post-order, and it can be printed only after printing both the left and the right child. So yet right child is to be printed, so we move towards the right. But C is again a parent, it cannot be processed because it is having a child Z. Z cannot be processed because it has a child M. So first M will be processed. After processing M, its parent Z is processed, after which its parent C is processed, and finally the root node A is processed. So in case of pre-order traversal, the root node is processed first, followed by all the nodes of its left subtree, followed by all the nodes of its right subtree. In case of inauditory traversal, the entire left subtree is processed first, followed by the root node, and then followed by all the nodes of its right subtree. In case of post-auditory traversal, first the left subtree is processed, then the entire right subtree is processed, and finally the root node is processed. So these are the three kind of tree traversal. Pre-order tree traversal, where the parent is processed or traversed first compared to the left child and the right child. In case of in-order, the parent is traversed in between the left and the right. And in case of post-order, the parent is processed after the left child and the right child. So we had studied what is binary search tree. We'll try to see what is the outcome of the tree traversal on the binary search tree. So we'll start with the pre-order tree traversal. In case of pre-order tree traversal, as we know, first we need to process the parent, followed by the left child, followed by the right child. So in this case, we start with the root node is 50, it is processed first. Then we move towards the left child, which is 40. Again, it has a left child 25. 25 doesn't have a left child, so now we'll move towards the right child, 30. And moving back to 40, the parent has been printed, its left child is printed, so now we'll print the right child, that is 45. Again, we move back towards the root node. In pre-order, first the root node is printed, followed by all the nodes of the left subtree, and now we need to print the all the nodes of the right subtree. Moving towards the right subtree, the first node that we encounter is 80, and it doesn't have a left child, so now we can move towards the right, so 120. So this is the outcome of pre-order traversal on the BST. We'll see what happens when we perform the in-order traversal on the BST. In case of in-order tree traversal, first we need to traverse the left child, followed by the parent, followed by the right child. So when we start with 50 as a root node, it cannot be processed because it has a left child. 40 in turn has a left child. The first node that will be printed is 25. It doesn't have a left child. So we have printed the parent 25, and now we'll print its right child, that is 30. Move back. With respect to 40, the left child is printed. So now we can print the parent, that is 40. After printing the left parent, now we can print the right child, that is 45. We'll move backwards. Now we process the parent of 40, that is 50. The left child is processed. Then we process the parent, and now we are going to process the right child, that is 80. And 80 doesn't have a left child, so now we can print 120. The speciality of in-order traversal on the binary search tree is it will always result in a sorted data in the ascending order. I repeat, we get a sorted data only when we perform the in-order traversal on the binary search tree. Then we'll perform, or we can say that is also one of the applications of binary search tree. When we perform the in-order traversal, we'll get the sorted data. The next type of traversal is the post-order traversal, where we process first the left child, then the right child, and then the parent. So in case of post order, the left child and the right child should be processed, and then finally the parent must be processed. So we'll start with the root node. It cannot be processed because it is having children. So we'll move towards the left. It cannot be processed because in turn it has a left child. This and again cannot be processed, though it doesn't have a left child, it has a right child. So the in case of post order, the parent can be traversed only after traversing both the left and the right child. So the first node that will be processed is the right child here because there is no left child. After printing the right child, the parent is processed. We move backwards. 40 cannot be processed because only left is printed. There is a right child. So we have 45 to be printed first or processed. So now both left and right are processed. We can process the parent 40. The left child is processed. We cannot print 50 because still it has a right child. So we move towards the right. This is again a parent. It cannot be processed unless and until the children are processed. So we'll process 120. After printing 120, we can process the parent, that is 80. And finally, after this, we can print the root node, that is 50. So in post order, the root node is processed at the end. In case of in order, first the left subtree is printed, then the root, and then the right subtree. In case of pre-order, first the root node followed by all the nodes of the left subtree followed by all the nodes of the right subtree. Point to be observed is when we perform in-order traversal, it will result in a sorted data. We'll try to now understand what is the outcome of the traversals on the binary expression tree. We had already studied what are binary expression tree in the previous class. So first we'll go for the pre-order tree traversal. So when you perform a pre-order tree traversal on a binary expression tree, it will result in a prefix arithmetic expression. Similarly, when you perform an in-order tree traversal on the binary expression tree, it results in infix expression, and post-order tree traversal on binary expression tree will result in a postfix arithmetic expression. So first we'll go for the pre-order tree traversal. In case of pre-order, always first the parent is processed, followed by the left child, followed by the right child. So in this tree, first, we start with the root node. So it is a parent, it is processed. We move towards the left. The left child is plus, followed by the next left child is A. A is a leaf node, doesn't have any children, goes back. The left is printed, the parent is printed. Now we can go for printing the right child, so B. So we have completed printing of the root node and the entire left subtree. Now we'll move towards the right subtree. So when you move towards the right, the first node that we encounter is minus. It is processed. After printing the parent, the left child. It is a leaf, doesn't have children, so goes back to parent, comes to the right child. Here, the parent is processed, followed by the left, followed by the Z. So this is nothing but your pre-order tree traversal. Coming to the in-order tree traversal. First left child, next parent, and next right child. So again, start from the root. It has a left child. So we keep on moving towards the left till we get the leftmost, or till we get a node which doesn't have any more left child. So start with slash, it has a left child plus, plus has a left child A. A doesn't have any children, so A is processed. After printing the left child, we are supposed to print the parent, so B, sorry, plus. So left child plus followed by the right child, that is B. Again, we move back to the root node, slash, coming towards the right subtree. We go for subtraction node, but this is a parent with the left child. So first left child is processed. It doesn't have any children, so comes back and processes the parent. After printing the left and the parent, we move towards the right. But this has again a child, left child. So first left child followed by the parent, star, followed by the right child, that is Z. So this is your in order tree traversal. In case of post order tree traversal, first the left child, next the right child, followed by parent. So in case of this tree, we start with the slash, which is a root node. It has a left child. This in turn has a left child. So first the leftmost child is printed. So this is a left child of parent plus. So left child is printed, followed by the right child, followed by the parent plus. This in turn is a left child, which is already printed. So now we can go towards the parent, but this has to be processed only after the right child is processed. So coming to this, minus is a parent. This can be processed only after processing its children. So we move towards the left, X is processed. X is a leaf, doesn't have any children, goes back to parent. It cannot be processed because still it has a right child to be processed. So move towards the right. And this parent has two children, Y and Z. So we have to process Y and Z first, followed by its parent, star. And now, since X and star both are processed, now we can go for subtraction. And since the entire left and the right subtree is processed, now we can go for finally processing the root node. So to summarize, when you perform the pre-order traversal on the binary expression tree, it results in a prefix expression. In-order tree traversal results in an infix expression, and post-order tree traversal results in a postfix arithmetic expression. Thank you.